Today I'll be answering questions on applying as a cabin crew and you're married, or you could be a single parent, or you might have kids. What about if you're already a cabin crew, you want to get married, or you want to have kids? Will there be maternity insurance, and so on and so forth? These questions I'll be answering in this episode today. For those of you who are new to this channel, my name is Mae Ville. I flew for Emirates for 12 years and I ended my flying career last year, 2020. Quite recently, a lot of airlines started to rehire again, and one of those is Emirates Airline. And I think because of that, I've been getting a lot of Emirates cabin crew related questions. So what I did is compile those questions according to its theme. Before I answer all your questions, let me just put it out there. What I will be sharing to you are my thoughts and my opinions based on my experience with Emirates, and it does not in any way represent the view of Emirates. So, let's begin. Question number one. Can I apply as an Emirates cabin crew even if I am married? Will I have a chance, or does Emirates only hire single people? It is not part of Emirates' requirements to be single for you to get hired. If you are married, you can apply for the Emirates cabin crew position. During my time when I was training with Emirates, I remember training with crew who were actually married already. So again, if you're married, that should not be a hindrance. Apply for Emirates. Next question. I am a single mom. Will this be a factor for Emirates to not hire me? Before I answer that question, if you are a single parent and you want to be a cabin crew, let me tell you, I really, really admire you. Being a parent is not easy, yet there you are doing all the best that you can to provide for your child. So again, I salute you. I admire you. With regards to my answer, it's going to be the same as my previous one. Emirates is not strict when it comes to your civil status or whether or not you have kids. Emirates will hire you based on your qualifications, based on how you performed during the assessment and how you answered your final interview. So if you're a single parent who wants to be a cabin crew, Emirates is open for you. And if you think that you have the qualifications, go for it. Okay, so I start shooting and the rain starts falling. So you might hear raindrops in the background, and hopefully that's okay. I'll proceed with the next question. I'm 29 years old, married with kids. Is it too late to apply? In the Emirates website, the minimum requirement for you to become an Emirates cabin crew is age 21. But then there is no limit. It doesn't say that just because you're 29, it's too late. So my dear, go apply. As you said, you're 29 years old, you're married, and you have kids. So let me break that down. You're married, it doesn't matter. You have kids, it doesn't matter. You're 29 years old, it doesn't matter. So again, click that application form. At age 29, you might have more experience already, more work experience as well. So use that to your advantage. Next. I know some airlines are very strict about getting married while under the employment contract. What is Emirates' rules on getting married? As I answer your questions, you will realize that Emirates is actually quite open to a lot of things, and getting married or being married is one of those. So back to your question, if you're somebody who joined Emirates and you were single, after joining Emirates you get married, Emirates is totally fine with that. If there's just one thing though, once you join Emirates, there will be a probation period for you, and that probation period is 6 months, at least during my time before I left, that was the case. So maybe if you plan to get married, maybe you just want to plan it or schedule it in a way that the date will be after your probation period, simply because while on probation, you will not be allowed to take leave. But apart from that, Emirates is cool with it. Next question. What happens if I marry a colleague, say a cabin crew also? What happens to my benefits? I'll answer this question based on what I saw and the rules during my time. And again, rules keep changing, but during my time, if you're a cabin crew and you get married to a cabin crew, whatever grade, all the benefits stay the same. As an example, say I'm a first class cabin crew, I get an accommodation allowance of 55,000 dirhams a year, or in Philippine pesos, that would be around 750,000 pesos a year. And I get married to a cabin crew who has pretty much the same allowance or more depending on my partner's position. When you get married, you still get both allowances. That is just the living allowance. That also includes your transportation allowance and even furniture loan. You get granted, he gets granted also. On to the next. Is there a rule on having kids? I heard of some airlines who let you go once you have kids. One, if you're married and you get pregnant and you decide to have a kid, and this is before finishing a 3-year contract, well then Emirates will let you go. It is stated in their company policy, well at least during my time. Number 2, say you've completed 3 years already with Emirates and then you get pregnant. Well, Emirates is totally fine with that. Emirates will keep you and in fact will support you all the way. Next question. Does Emirates provide maternity leave? And if yes, will the insurance cover the delivery? Let me make this clear first. If you're married and you declare to Emirates that you're pregnant, Emirates, yes, will grant you maternity leave. So this is on the day that you actually declare to Emirates that you're pregnant, that your maternity leave starts. Okay, so that's clear. Remember, as I said, the rules of Emirates keep changing. And when I was with Emirates, which was more than a decade, I saw rules being changed here and there. And one of that is maternity leave and insurance also. Back in the days, say you're married and you declare to Emirates that you're pregnant, Emirates will, yes, immediately grant you maternity leave. However, that's it. There will be no insurance provided for you. So that was during my first few years with Emirates. And a couple of years later, the rules changed. If, say, you're married and you declare to Emirates that you're pregnant, the new rule states that during your pregnancy and on your delivery, it will be covered by your insurance. As an example, I was already under the new rule of me being provided maternity insurance. So when I got pregnant, the day I declared it to Emirates until I gave birth, my maternity insurance under Emirates covered it all. After my delivery, I didn't pay anything at all except for the coffee that my husband and my sister drank, which was 130 pesos. So that was it. With regards to the maternity insurance that you will get, during my time, my maternity insurance coverage was 25,000 dirhams for normal delivery, so that would be around 345,000 worth of coverage. That is under normal delivery. However, if you do cesarean or CS section, so that would be around 480,000 pesos. And again, that's already a good amount of money. Next question. Will I get paid while on maternity leave? Well, again, rules change. The moment I declared that I was pregnant, I stopped receiving a salary. This is from the moment I declared until I gave birth. However, I think, if I'm not mistaken, Emirates paid me 45 days worth of maternity leave, but the rest during my whole time of pregnancy and the time before I started my training again, I was not paid. However, as I said, the rules keep changing. A couple of months after I gave birth, Emirates then released a new rule stating that the moment that you declare to Emirates that you're pregnant until the time that you go back to training, Emirates will still provide for you an accommodation allowance. Again, it changes and it changes for the better. So again, these times, if you get pregnant and you declare that to Emirates, Emirates will now give you certain allowances. Next question. How many weeks or months does Emirates give after giving birth before one needs to fly again? So I think the question is, how many weeks will you be on ground before you start flying again? I can say, based on my experience, I think Emirates gave me 120 days or something like that to just be on ground and be with my child. So that was really good, because I know some companies who only had 2 weeks of maternity leave and, you know, they had to go back to work already. So I was very blessed, and that's something that I'm very grateful for Emirates, because I really had a lot of time with my son before I went back to flying. However, this is something that I know, which I also heard from the crew themselves who underwent through this experience, is, say for example, you give birth and after a month or 2 months you feel like you're now ready to go back online, you can actually email Emirates and say, hey, I know it's not 100 days yet, but I'm ready to go back to flying. And Emirates, depending on the demand, will put you back online. Once you go back, you don't immediately fly, you undergo a training again, which is good because it will be sort of a refresher for you. You know, some practical assessments and quizzes again. Really the bottom line of why the mother needs to undergo training again, because Emirates wants to make sure that every cabin crew that goes up in the air is and remains to be sharp. Last question. Do I go back to the lowest grade when I come back after giving birth? That's the good thing when you work for Emirates, because you get to retain your position. So when I got pregnant, I was already a first class cabin crew. So when I came back as a first class crew. So it's really good because you get to retain your position. So there you go, guys. Some of your questions being answered. Hopefully it gave you again an insight as to how it is working and flying for Emirates Airline. If there's something that I want you to take away from this, working for Emirates is a wonderful opportunity. And I said this before, Emirates is really open to certain things such as being married or having kids or being a single parent or say, for example, having kids after joining Emirates and even providing you with an insurance and still paying you while you are in maternity leave. So these are things that I believe what makes Emirates also a wonderful airline to work for. So if you're someone who's aspiring to work for Emirates, really I say this, especially to those people who message me privately, and I always say I'm rooting for you and I'm really wishing you all the best. Your time with Emirates, if ever you get hired, will be a remarkable one. And having said that, I hope you found value in this video. Take care, stay safe, and I'll see you again next time.